I'm in a cave deep down under the ground and I can't see anything. It really feels like being out in space. I feel lost.
This is the entrance to Mars, also known as the cave, and now there's no way back.
My spacesuit is waiting for me at the airlock.
It's the first time in years that someone helps me in my shoes.
I'm wearing torso protection underneath in case I slip and hurt myself.
Ready. Ready, Commander. I'm sweating and sweating, and the surface is really slippery, so every step is dangerous. If I fall, I'll fall deep down somewhere in the cave that I don't see. So, whew, this is not as I expected it to be.
I set off to collect samples, exactly as astronauts on Mars would be doing. Tomorrow, I'll analyze them in the lab.
Okay. I'm trying to take some samples here, although I can see barely anything. But it's the first time in my life that I think that I'm doing something meaningful for science.
Commander to Astrolander 1, return to safe habitat.
Astrolander 1 for Commander, copy that.
The mock space station is located 1.5 kilometers into the Spanish cave. This is home for tonight.
I really need to go to the loo, and yes, there is a toilet, but privacy. For you personally, staying here, what was your most interesting or the most challenging experience?
As soon as the days keep passing by, you really understand that you are more or less isolated from real life. We don't have any kind of connection with normal kind of, you know, internet or these kind of things. And as well, we should say that nutrition and the kind of diets we have in here is something as well affecting you mentally.
Speaking of food.
This is basically the kitchen in our habitat. I can choose, well, I'll take a stew. And then I prepared some hot water, and that's all you need. Now you just wait for 10 minutes and then bon appetit. It feeds you. Fernando, it's been really a tough day. Now it's over, we have finished. The perfect time for a cold beer, isn't it?
Definitely, but you know exactly the protocols we have here on Mars, so you will have to deal with something else instead.
Okay, so the best that I can get is this mousse au chocolat.
No alcohol in there.
Oh, I'm done for today. Now it's time to sleep. But when I packed my stuff for this journey, I wasn't really sure how scared I would be down here, so I brought my little companion for the night.
I get some well-deserved shut-eye. Our subterranean mission is monitored around the clock from this control center, located an hour's drive from the cave. Day 2 begins.
Good morning. Coffee first. So I slept well. I mean, after the really hectic day yesterday with all the hard work outside, I slept like a little baby, and looking forward to what happens today. So this is the bathroom. With water being a very rare resource on Mars, it's more wiping than washing.
back to work. Today I'm analyzing the moss samples I scraped from the cave's rocks.
So, Fernando, why are these samples from the cave interesting for scientists?
Look, Axel, these are one of the most primary forms of life that we could find either here on Earth or on Mars. I have as well to give you a note that currently we have discovered a type of life that we have never found before on Earth. So nowadays, here in Astroland, we have this specific type of form that we're trying to make some research on.
Astrolander 1 for mission control. I'm ready to leave the safe habitat, returning to Earth. Over and out.
Axel?
Yes?
You arrived here as an ask candidate, and now you will live like an Astrolander.
Yes, I'm an Astrolander! Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
So I really had a tough time here in this cave on planet Mars, but it was loads of fun. My resume, well, to be honest, I'm not made for Mars. And what about you? Are you ready for Mars? Please leave it in the comments.